To me, that begs the question, where did that very large number of independents come from? Were they independents returned by the people, or were they independents, with all due respect to the Election Commission, created by the Election Commission on its faulty understanding of the Constitution and in particular the judgment of the Supreme Court, which upheld their order? They said it meant this. We didn't say this. It didn't mean this at all. So you see, when we are in this realm, if this is the correct position, that this whole problem or issue is arising out of errors made by the Election Commission, then surely it is the, or is it not, the duty of the court, the Supreme Court, to the extent that it is able to do that, to correct that error, to rectify the problem, and if there are alternate pathways available, legally available, to choose the one that results in the error being rectified, and either for that problem, quote unquote, of reserved seats, the excess reserved seats, going to political parties who are not really entitled to that because that tips the balance, that problem being disappeared because the reserved seats go to some political party to which is entitled, or maybe keeping the resultant vacancies to a minimum. I mean, seems to me surely that is the correct way to interpret and apply the Constitution.
My Lord,
rather than just saying no, the seats cannot lie vacant. No, I am sorry, I don't, with all due respect, look at it that way. I think the Constitution assumes that the seats will not lie vacant, and therefore, in terms of 22.4, expressly creates a situation where the Constitution says, look, this is the working basis of the Constitution, but here...
Not looking at 51.6, forget the reserve seats, just to understand how this process works, because you said...
Yes, they become a parliamentary party, a political party does become a parliamentary party, where its candidate or nominee actually wins a seat and goes into the assembly.
So it starts off at the election, on the election date, as being not a political party, and then subsequently down the line somewhere it attains the status of a political party and becomes a parliamentary party.
No, two things.
Two to nahi hote na.
Mr. Attorney General, the answer is one, the 3 days, you're overlooking the 3 days aspect.
Sir,
वो जो 3 दिन में आपको ज्वाइन करना था, जो एग्जिस्टिंग चीजें, जो सब्सिक्वेंट चीजों को तो आप उस 3 दिन में नहीं ज्वाइन कर सकते हो, जो चीज अभी हुई नहीं उसको आप कैसे ज्वाइन कर सकते हो?
I'll just
introduce.
Can you conclude now?
जी, बस मैं आपके कंक्लूजन की तरफ.
One possible interpretation to this could also be, I'm just placing it on, on the table, because 63A2 could be one set, and 51D could be yet another way of becoming a parliamentary party, irrespective of the reserved seat. So, the minute the independents join a political party off the shelf, forget the reserved seat angle, they become a parliamentary party because the winnings have been brought into a political party off the shelf. That could be yet a third way of becoming a parliamentary party, but has nothing to do with 51D, because uske liye to baki requirements bhi chahiye.
Ye jo political,
with respect, my lord,
the other is that you read it together.
Ye jo parliamentary party hai, ye 63A ke liye hai. ये जो
उसी के लिए ही है वही प्रोविजन है जो लीड करती है पार्लियामेंट्री पार्टी. मैं तो सिर्फ ये कह रहा हूँ,
आपको आगे बढ़ना,
बस आगे चलता हूँ. एक कंक्लूजन यहाँ पे, एक फाइनल सेंटेंस कह के एंड रिटरेट है. Independent returns candidates can only join such political party which must have won one seat in a house, because they will only be able to become a member of parliamentary party of that party and no other party which has no seat. Now I come to this last submission, my lord, and this last submission deals with the broader question also. Before this court, you have proceedings under Article 185(3). There is a political party, Sunni Ittehad Council, who is the appellant number one, along with its chairman, who is appellant number two. They are aggrieved of the decision of the election commission, which was upheld by, they are aggrieved of the decision of Peshawar High Court, which had upheld the decision of the election commission, whereby, whereunder the reserve seats, they were not, reserve seats were not allocated to Sunni Ithehad Council as claimed by it. And they were treated as independents for the purposes of allocation of reserved seats, and consequently the seats went to the other parties in accordance with the formula, in accordance with the rules and the formula which has been followed. My lords, I've also observed that while looking at this list, why can't this court, invoking 187, pass an appropriate order or direction? My respectful submission to this is that 187, and I first want to read it out before making submissions of one, clause 1 of 187, just quick read, just want to point out one part of it. One. I'll just read clause 1, sir. Subject to clause 2 of article 175, the Supreme Court shall have power to issue such directions, orders or decrees as may be necessary for doing complete justice, a pause, in any case or matter pending before it. In any case, matter or pending before it, if you may kindly underline it. My lord, article 187 is a power which has been conferred upon the Supreme Court. It is not a jurisdiction. This power can only be exercised when a case is competently filed and is pending before your lordships under 184, 185 or 188. No independent proceedings can be initiated under 187.
What does this mean, any case? For doing complete justice in any case
or matter pending before it. So it is any case which in the jurisdictions which this court has under 184, 185 or 188. I can't imagine under 186 something of this sort happening, but let's, for the sake of discussion, 186.
It is a case pending.
Yes, but while the case is pending before you, you'd look at the case what is made out before. The case brought before you, the case made out for you, and the case which is being responded to. And while doing so,
खत्म हो गया ये बात.
अगर देखिए इसमें अगर बात ये है कि अब आपने सदीकी साहब के दो लेटर्स पे आपने कहा कि जो दो लेटर दिखाए गए इलेक्शन कमीशन के इख्तियार नहीं थे.
आपसे वो रिस्पॉन्ड कर लेंगे, बट मेरा ख्याल है कि
आपसे एक सवाल पूछें. एज आप तो चूंकि 27A में आए हैं, आप फेडरल गवर्नमेंट को रिप्रेजेंट नहीं कर, आप कोर्ट नोटिस पे हैं, तो आपने लॉ पे हमें असिस्ट करना है. आप ये बता दें कि जब नॉमिनेशन पेपर फाइल होती है, एक कैंडिडेट कह देता है कि मैं डिक्लेरेशन देता हूँ फलां पार्टी से हूँ, और उस पर सर्टिफिकेट भी आ जाता है, विड्रॉल डेट गुजरने के बाद, क्या उस कैंडिडेट के पास ये इख्तियार है कि वो विड्रॉ कर जाए, नंबर वन, विड्रॉल डेट गुजरने के बाद, या क्या इलेक्शन कमीशन को किस कानून के तहत ये इख्तियार है कि वो कहते नो यू आर इंडिपेंडेंट? ये सवाल, क्योंकि आप अगर देखें 72 में, सेक्शन 72, कैंडिडेट के पास सिर्फ एक ही रेमेडी है कि वो रिटायरमेंट ले रहे हैं. 74, सॉरी
जी,
सेक्शन 74 ऑफ द एक्ट.
72 सर,
74,
72 सर, रिटायरमेंट 72,
रिटायरमेंट 72, 72 रिटायरमेंट
जी.
तो कैंडिडेट अगर एप्लीकेशन दे भी दे के मैं आजाद हूँ, क्या वो आजाद मींस विड्रॉइंग फ्रॉम द एफिलिएशन ऑफ दैट पार्टी, कैन ही विड्रॉ हिमसेल्फ?
मैं आपको जरा कुछ थोड़ा सा ब्रीफली इस पे एक्सप्लेन करके देन आई टेक
ये yes. सवाल इम्पोर्टेंट है. देखिए ना, सवाल ये है कि जब ये बात होती है कि वो व्हाइल वी लुकिंग एट द केस फ्रॉम वन एंड, ये सारा इलेक्शन है ना जी, पूरा इलेक्शन, पूरे इलेक्शन में हम एक पोर्शन को पकड़ लिया, हमने कहा SIC पॉलिटिकल पार्टी है कि नहीं, और उनके पास रिजर्व सीट्स आती. अब हम जब कंप्लीट जस्टिस की लेंस को खोलते हैं, तो हम कहते हैं ठहरो ना, हम आंखें तो नहीं बंद कर सकते इस पे कि SIC पे हम कहाँ से पहुंचे हैं. SIC में इसलिए पहुंचे हैं कि हैड द इलेक्शन कमीशन डिक्लेयर्ड PTI एज अ पार्टी विद वट एवर 2, 3, 4 कैंडिडेट, इंडिपेंडेंट्स वुड हैव हैड अ चॉइस दैट देयर वाज अ PTI आल्सो. वी ऑल अंडरस्टैंड दैट ऑल दोज इंडिपेंडेंट्स हैव वन द इलेक्शन बिकॉज दे हेल्ड आउट टू द पब्लिक दे वर PTI पीपल. All those votes were casted for these 84 people because they were PTI. It's obvious. अब हैविंग सेड दैट नाउ वी से ओके वो सारा चीज जो है हमें हमने नहीं देखना एकदम और हम ये देखने लग जाए थोड़ा सा पोर्शन तो फिर कंप्लीट जस्टिस को और हमने क्या करना है इस क्लॉज को कि अगर हम पूरी पिक्चर ही ना देख सके
वो आपको दिखाए
इसमें, इसमें नहीं, ना दिखाए
बट मैं ये आपको ये कह रहा हूं
कहना चाह रहे हैं कि कंप्लीट जस्टिस को क्या कहां लेकर जाना है अगर हम ये चीजों पे आंखें बंद करने लग जाए इधर उधर और घोड़े की तरह इस तरह वो लगा के चलने लग जाए कंप्लीट जस्टिस इज टू ब्रॉडन द विजन सी द होल ट्रांजैक्शन
अटॉर्नी जनरल
विद द लिमिटेशंस
अटॉर्नी जनरल जी साहब आपने शायद वो तस्वीर देखी है जो जज की आंखों पे पट्टी होती है
एडिंग
ये नहीं होती
एडिंग टू व्हाट माय लॉर्ड जस्टिस मंसूर अली शाह हैज जस्ट स्टेटेड व्हाट यू हैव आर्ग्यूड इज इन अदर वर्ड्स यू आर आस्किंग दिस एपिक्स कोर्ट वेस्टेड विद ज्यूरिसडिक्शन एक्स्ट्राऑर्डिनरी ज्यूरिसडिक्शंस एज वेल that only look at 185 and thus what would be the effect? The effect would be during these proceedings one thing has become absolutely obvious that there has been a grave constitutional violation by excluding a political party on the basis of misinterpretation of the provisions and a judgment of this court. So now indirectly this apex court would be validating a grave constitutional violation and thus invoking the doctrine of necessity again. Now this is not an ordinary 185 litigation. It relates to the rights of the people, particularly those who by now is very clear have been disfranchised by an unconstitutional interpretation by a constitutional body and you want this court to validate it.
And adding to that, I mean, all we want to say, adding to that, this is not a case ke patwari ne zameen kisi ki inter-party le li hai, toh humne kaha 185 mein dekhna hai, wo order aapne challenge nahi ki, aap nahi kar sakte. This is not that. Please try to look at this as an election matter, which is perhaps something that one has to look into. It's a sui generis. It's a different kind of set of proceedings. Go under 185. We're looking at the electorate, we're looking at the national elections, we're looking, I mean, the apex court, national election, the electorate, the millions of people who voted. What I find very difficult is to look one segment of the election and ignore a very grave illegality that occurred just a minute before it, which led to that problem. So can we not attend it and close our eyes to it? Because if you open your eyes to it, all you have to do is that if three persons, according to the record, if ECP checks, PTI becomes a party of three members of four. And then there is a party on the table, and then the independents have a choice to take their vote. Everything falls in place. So if that is not what justice is, I don't know what justice is.
My Lord,
since a lot has been said from this side, and since I may not subscribe to a number of things that don't expect this, justice, we all want justice, but it's a very elusive concept. If you go on personal justice, my concept may be different from your concept. Someone may be in favor of capital punishment, someone may be against it. On a justice principle, do we apply justice principles? We apply the law and the constitutional provisions. Now, read all the judgments of this court, which introduce the doctrine of necessity, and all of them rely upon the justice principle. Les populi, Kensel's pure theory of law. This is actually they had lost the thing of the people. Every judgment has been based on premise. If they had simply followed the constitution and said, this is not permissible, you cannot take over, you cannot send elected representatives home. That would be the letter of the constitution. I'm not even going to the spirit of the constitution. When judges, some of them may have great wisdom, I am not one of those, say, forget what the constitution say, there is this one word, justice, and I'm going to erect an edifice on the basis of this one word, then we might as well do away with the constitution, because we are now imposing our vision on the nation. We are imposing what the constitution says, hang on, constitution makers, you didn't quite get it right. We know what justice is. We are imposing our will on parliament. When we go into these vague concepts, we get into all sorts of troubles, which are history. It's not academic anymore. Since mention was made of doctrine of necessity, it was on these very principles. When they can't find anything tangible to hang on to in the constitution, then opens the doors, because I can define justice any way I want to, someone else will define it any other way. So are we going to have this academic, and this is not even something which has really been argued, and I don't want to stick my neck out or let it come from as if it's a thing of the court saying this, that the doctrine of necessity was done. I think on the very principle, or the principle, or the concept, or what they borrowed, what they in their hearts or in their conscience, I would even go that far, they genuinely believed it. I wouldn't even say that, I wouldn't even attribute any malefide or ill intent to any of those judges. They genuinely believed it. I don't want be, let's Pakistan go on the constitutional path for once.
London comes, I think you finished your
You haven't answered my question. Do we validate,
these are our opinions,
do we validate a grave constitutional violation which has become obvious before us? That is inclusion
on something.
That is not premised. That is the orders have come before us. It has become obvious.
Do you want to respond?